Hello, my name is Mark Silverstein, and welcome to All Things Antares. In this episode, we will be discussing safe cockpit designs for cruising catamarans. In today's market, we can categorize cockpit design into two categories. The first category are the charter catamarans, the weekend sailors, and what I would term the coastal cruisers. And in the second bucket, we have those boats that are designed for true blue water cruising, those boats that will be sailing anywhere from 1 week to 2 weeks to 3 weeks on any given passage. And the differences are important because when you are sailing offshore, the weather conditions can change very quickly, and how your cockpit is designed can be the difference of being safe or potentially unsafe, and even in some cases, deadly. And so that is what we are here to discuss in this episode. So what makes a cockpit design safe? In most sailing conditions, sailors experience what we would say in general, pretty comfortable, calm conditions, 1 meter, 2 meter seas. That's anywhere from 2 to 3 to 4 to 5 feet. You've got typical 15, 18 knots of wind. And in those types of conditions, most cockpit designs are safe. It's when you're offshore and the weather changes dramatically, you have a low pressure system coming in, and the sea state goes from 2 to 3 meters to 4 to 5 meters, and then you have 30 to 40 to 50 knots of wind, breaking sea conditions, and that is when you're going to think to yourself, maybe I should have thought about the cockpit design when I purchased this boat to have ensured that it was as safe as possible given those different types of extreme sea conditions. And the different ways that catamarans are designed and the cockpits are designed are very important and all too often overlooked by buyers on the market today. So let's go into some of those details. First of all, we can put the key design considerations into 5 different categories. The first one has to do with breaking water and the sea state that you will encounter when you have breaking waves on a boat. The U.S. Coast Guard and the U.S. Navy have done a number of different research, in fact, a lot of different research, on what happens to vessels when they encounter breaking seas. And let's just put this in perspective a little bit. The U.S. Coast Guard gives a couple different examples. One of them is this. Typically, when you're encountering breaking sea state, the wave velocity, the crashing wave, is traveling at over 20 knots and carrying tons and tons of water crashing onto that vessel. So you have to say, as a designer, what are some of the things that you would need to do to keep your vessel safe in a crashing, breaking wave sea state? And so if you think about it and you said, what if we were to go through and to minimize the ability of water to be able to ingress into that cockpit? In other words, thinking about how can we limit the amount of water in a potential breaking wave situation to enter that cockpit. So you would want to then minimize, within reason, the size of that footprint for that cockpit to limit the amount of water that would come into the vessel, possibly into the vessel, and be an issue for the crew or for the safety of that vessel. In addition to the footprint of the cockpit, wouldn't it be a good idea to be able to have an aft bulwark that would be high enough and provide enough of an entry barrier to, again, limit the amount of water coming into that vessel from a breaking sea state? So that is something else that you would need to at least think about in your catamaran design. In addition to that, think about the entrance from the cockpit into the salon. And wouldn't that entrance need to be at least big enough to be comfortable to come back and forth from the cockpit into the salon, but not so big that it creates a structure that is difficult mechanically to be able to provide a safe barrier from the cockpit to the salon? And in some designs, you will see all of those sliding doors will open into a very vast space, which looks beautiful from the cockpit into the salon. But in a serious breaking wave situation, that may not be the safest design. In fact, we believe it's not the safest design. And that is why our design is set up very differently, where we have a very strong structure between the cockpit and the salon with the sliding glass door that we have in place on our boat. So that's, again, another consideration for design on keeping the people, crew, safe in extreme weather conditions. And that's why we also think that a forward-facing doors on any sort of a Bluewater catamaran is generally a bad idea. We want to provide a safe space for the crew to be able to be safe in those types of conditions and not be worried about a breach in a door that's facing forward when tons and tons of water come crashing in at 20-plus knots, smashing into that door and causing some sort of a breach or a failure. That is not something that we think is something that the crew should be worried about on a blue water passage. The next design consideration to think about is protection from the elements for the person on watch at the helm. You think about the wind, you think about the rain, you think about being cold, and you put all the combinations of bad weather conditions, howling wind, lots of rain, cold crew members that are wet and not dry, as something that is very significant to think about. And that's why if you look at some designs, and we'll just take this design as an example, on the Antares, and that's we have a glass windshield that covers the entire front of the boat. It provides a protective barrier. It's glass, and we're not talking about vinyl anything. It's all glass. It's strong structurally. It has windshield wipers. It provides that barrier of the wind and the seas coming crashing in those types of conditions. In addition, you want to be able to lower the side enclosures very quickly. In fact, you want to be able to be fully enclosed 360 degrees in those types of situations. There's nothing worse than being wet and cold and in very bad weather. The last thing you want to have happen is to be making bad decisions because you're not well rested and you're just fully exhausted and chilled. So that is another consideration to be thinking about, is how protected is the helmsperson in any type of conditions, and how easy is it to put that protection in place, i.e. rolling down those side enclosures. In addition to that, you want to be able to have 360 degree visibility. You want to be able to sit in that helm and look around 360 to see any sort of threats or any sort of issues that may be happening. The last thing you want to do is have to get up from the helm, walk around to another point on the boat to be able to see somewhere that was a blind spot to you as you sat at that helm. So again, think about the importance of being able to be in one place, you're clipped in bad weather, and be able to see what's happening from any direction around you without having to get up and move around on a vessel that's already smashing through the seas. And you also want to be thinking about having a very good handholds as you move around the boat in the cockpit. There are some cockpit designs that are beautiful. They're massive, very expansive, but the reality is to get from one side of the cockpit to the other, there are no handholds. So you have to kind of essentially skate across if you're in wet floors, surging sea state, and that's not very safe. You don't want to twist an ankle, slip, or fall down. You want to be able to, as you're walking through that cockpit, grabbing a hold of secure places above you, and even leaning on something as you're kind of walking around to be able to tweak or adjust a sail, put in a reef, or whatever you might be doing as you maneuver through that cockpit in bad weather. It's something that most sailors have a rule in place on their boats, and it goes something like this. It's one hand for yourself and one hand for the boat. And so that just simply means you need to have a handhold, and wherever you go, wherever you're walking around, to be able to reach and hold and grab onto something as you're moving around. That also makes a cockpit a safe design. Think also about this next consideration. That's how easy is it to get to the cockpit? Do you have to climb up a flight of stairs to get to the cockpit? Do you have to climb down, you know, slide down maybe in some situations a bunch of stairs to get out of the cockpit? Just imagine if you had an emergency, you're inside and you see something happen and you have to get to that helm very quickly to be able to make some sort of an adjustment to the boat. Do you want to climb up a bunch of stairs to do that? The answer is logically no. You wouldn't want to do that, especially in a really nasty sea state. That's just not a safe design. It's a beautiful design if you want to be able to sit up on top and lounge in the sun on your vacation. It's an entirely poor design if you want to be doing that as you're making a long blue water passage going from point A to point B in some really nasty weather. It's not something that we would consider by any stretch, I think, a safe design for those types of sea states and sea conditions. And finally, you want to be able to manage your sails in those types of conditions. You don't want to have to go forward. You want to be able to have all the lines running into the cockpit so that you can go through and add a reef, douse a sail, or furl in your Genoa, whatever it might be. You want to be able to do it from the cockpit. And one of the things that we are really proud about at Antares is we were one of the first catamaran manufacturers to bring all lines to the helm. It now seems to be a lot more of a trend that you see this happening a lot more, which is a good thing, by the way, bringing all lines to the cockpit. But that wasn't the case just not too many years ago by a lot of catamaran manufacturers. And that is an okay design if you're going to be sailing coastal navigation, possibly chartering. It's not a very good idea if you want to be safe on a very long passage in tough weather. So let's hear from some of our customers and what they have to say about the cockpit design of the Antares and why they think, in their own words, it's a safe cockpit.
So one of the places we spend the most time is in this cockpit. And I've always felt safe in this cockpit. There's always somewhere for me to grab a hold of. I feel secure and protected. It's nice and close together, so I always have a handhold nearby. I can set down my coffee as I'm going out to change the sails. Everything is within a hand's reach, and that's really helped give me confidence on my sailing, and also as a parent having children on board, being able to keep them in this enclosed area and have them feel like they can hold on to things and I can make sure that they're safe as well. So it's a safe, protected cockpit. The design makes everything easy to grab onto, and in heavy sea states or tropical storms, we've been through it all, and it's always made me feel secure to be in here.
So in conclusion, at Antares, we design our boats with extreme weather conditions in mind. It is our philosophy to not compromise on a design that might add a little extra bling for some marketing exercise versus actually keeping our crew and our vessel safe in these types of conditions. That is why we believe the Antares is the world's best liveaboard.